welcome with great joy everybody joining us through the streaming. The first time we stream as the Missionary Oblates, the beginning of our general chapter. It is the 36th general chapter of the Missionary Oblates of Mary Immaculate on a very special occasion, the 200th anniversary of our congregation. The general chapter is the time when, as a congregation, we meet with all those elected to give new direction to the congregation, to choose the new administration, and to breathe a new hope, a new life, into the works we have as the Missionary Oblates. We began today with the Holy Eucharist, celebrated at 9 a.m. with Father Louis Logan, the Superior General of the Missionary Oblates. Now, as you see, we are preparing to process into the main hall, the Aula Magna, where for the next month the general chapter will take place.
Bonjour à tous. Je suis Dernoudi Homme de l'Etienne du Tchad, au Scolastique International de Rome. Et vous nous voyez aujourd'hui dans la joie parce que nous venons à peine de célébrer la messe qui nous ouvre notre chapitre général. Nous sommes actuellement dans la maison des frères des écoles chrétiennes où se tient le chapitre. Et comme vous nous voyez, nous sommes donc dans la grande salle où se tiendra vraiment le chapitre général. Ce matin, donc, nous avons commencé ce chapitre, déjà, disons, avec la messe d'ouverture qui a eu lieu à 9h, suivi d'un petit moment de récréation. Et actuellement, nous attendons tous ceux qui sont des participants, qui viendront donc en procession en chantant le Veni Creator, qui est une invocation à l'Esprit Saint. Et il faut dire que le chapitre général est un moment important pour nous. C'est déjà le 36e chapitre général de notre congrégation. Et nous sommes aussi dans le jubilé. Dans le bicentenaire, ça fait déjà 200 ans que nous existons comme Oblats. De 1816 à 2016, nous sommes alors exactement à 200 ans d'existence. Alors vous nous voyez là actuellement donc dans le streaming où nous diffusions en direct, c'est pour la première fois dans l'histoire que vous pouvez nous entendre et nous suivre de longtemps. Nous vous remercions.
Buenos días a todos y todas. Bienvenidos hermanos y hermanas a esta emisión en directo por internet, vía streaming. En este 14 de septiembre comenzamos los Oblatos de María Inmaculada, el 36 capítulo general de la congregación. Un capítulo muy especial, un año muy especial, 200 años de existencia, el bicentenario, un jubileo. Hoy hemos comenzado este capítulo con la Eucaristía a las 9 de la mañana, hora de Roma. Después de una pequeña pausa, vamos a comenzar una procesión entonando el canto, un himno al Espíritu Santo, pidiendo que nos inspire y nos ilumine en este capítulo en el que los oblatos discernimos, buscamos caminos para afrontar, para responder de la mejor forma posible a la misión que el Señor nos presenta a los pobres. Ese es el tema de este capítulo. Evangelizade pauperibus misit me. Bienvenidos y creo que ahora en directo van a estar viendo imágenes de la procesión desde la iglesia principal, de la Casa de LaSalle, donde estamos celebrando el capítulo, hasta esta sala capitular, donde ya podrán tener el audio.
Serdecznie witamy wszystkich, którzy za pośrednictwem mediów łączą się z nami w tym szczególnym momencie, w dniu rozpoczęcia naszej 36. kapituły. Ojcowie biorący udział w kapitule w tym właśnie momencie procesyjnie przechodzą z kaplicy, w której miała miejsce msza rozpoczęcia, której przewodniczył ojciec generał Louis Logen, i udają się w kierunku sali konferencyjnej, gdzie będzie miało rozpoczęcie nasza kapituła. Jest to pierwszy raz, kiedy rozpoczęcie kapituły jest transmitowane za pośrednictwem mediów. Un caro benvenuto a tutti che si collegano con noi attraverso lo streaming. Fra poco cominceremo primo incontro dell'Assemblea di Capitolo Generale. È un momento molto importante perché questa volta Capitolo Generale viene svolto durante il nostro anniversario di 200 anni della nostra congregazione. In questo momento i padri capitolari si spostano dalla cappella, dove ha avuto luogo la messa presieduta da Padre Generale LOUGEN, e verranno qui nella sala dei incontri, dove cominceremo insieme il nostro capitolo. Durante la processione viene cantato l'inno Vieni Creator Spiritus e stiamo aspettando la venuta dei padri.
Bonjour à tout le monde.
Bonjour.
Mon nom est devant moi, Bernard Keradec. Je parlerai principalement en français. Simplement au début, nous allons regarder comment fonctionne le système pour la traduction simultanée. Dans vos documents, à la feuille 2.6, vous avez toutes les explications voulues. Le canal 1, c'est la langue française. Le 2, la langue anglaise. Et le 3e, la langue espagnole. Alors... You will find your kit for the earphone in your pulpit. Vous allez trouver vos écouteurs dans les tables. Sans les écouteurs, évidemment, c'est un peu difficile. Voilà, tout le monde a pu trouver ce qu'il lui faut. Est-ce que la langue française, le premier canal, marche, je suppose? La traduction au canal 2 pour l'anglais, est-ce que ça marche? Oui, très bien, merci. Et le troisième pour la langue espagnole, est-ce que ça fonctionne bien? Merci. Voilà. Et puis tout de suite, puisque nous sommes dans le feuillet 2.6 dans vos documents, pour prendre la parole en session plénière, la première chose à faire, c'est de élever votre main pour que nous puissions savoir qui veut prendre la parole. Quelquefois, il y a 2-3 personnes en attente. Il est donc important, non pas de commencer à parler, mais de lever votre main pour que nous puissions noter qui veut prendre la parole. Ensuite, le modérateur en charge vous donnera la parole. À ce moment-là, vous pressez le petit bouton rouge et votre micro s'allume. Vous dites tout d'abord votre nom. C'est très important. Et ensuite, dans quelle langue vous allez vous exprimer. Ceci pour faciliter la tâche au traducteur et à nous tous pour régler la traduction. Est-ce bien clair? Oui? Yes? Si? Ok, thank you.
As requested, I am Father Claudio Bertuccio. I am here as the chapter commissioner. I will speak in English now. As requested by the chapter directory number 36, after having examined the documentation concerning all the members of the chapter, in my function of chapter commissioner, I certify that the following oblates have the credentials to be rightfully members, ex officio, elected delegates and invited of the 36th General Chapter of the Missionary Oblates of Mary Immaculate. When I will call your name, please stand up and acknowledge your presence. Albergati Tejera Jorge. Anthony David Kumar, Anton William, Archiati Paolo, Adstrak Mario, Blackley James, Boatil Sydney, Boch Anthony, Brown Warren, Currens Ronald, Carillo Francisco, Castillo Villegas José Luis, Corain Daniel, Domkowski Rafal, Dagavanansu Edward, De Gia Lauro, De Los Reyes, Jerry Gamaniel, De Sirol, Mark, Diaconu Jean-Marie, Favero Bruno, Fini Christian, Forster Kenneth, Fritz Miguel, Garcia Noel, Garcia Moreno Ismael, Gil Marian, Giorgianni Maurizio, Niemi Alberto, Griffin Liam, Gruber Vincent, Guaman Camayo Alberto, Yashevsky Andrei, Kadlik Vlasmil, Kalish Slavomir, Kaspersky Marius, Kibongwe Freeborn, Klui Wojciech, Langley Jacques, Lepage Remy, Logan Louis, Made Andre, Mamani Calixto, Mariangeli Antonio, Martinez Morales, Massoso Anthony, Mazibuko Vuzumuzi, Mazil Ludeger, Mosemedi Lucas, Mosueo Emmanuel, Mutunda Guillaume, Napvenje Charles, Ngoka Cornelius, Nsolo Habel, Oberkfeld Stefan, Ovono di Ferdinand, Pignon Gilberto, Prentin Jean-François, Pulkni Christopher, Rajabana Antonius, Ratokoa Mokone, Royce Alonso Luis Ignacio, Rosato Gennaro, Rossignol Jason, Rosairo Bradley, Rubo Francisco, Ruiz Iriarte Ivar, Sandapan Chinnapan, Sarkar Dilip, Selvaratnam Edwin, Silva Jude Rohan, Studder Lewis, Tagar James, Tardif Luke, Thorson Kenneth, Tran Quang Quang Emmanuel, Tremblay Pierre Olivier, Vervus George, Wadyasekara Clement, Varnakula Surya Derek Vernon. He is absent because he is the elected delegate for Pakistan and he will join the chapter only starting from September 16 due to visa problems. So he will not be able to enter Italy before that date. He will join us on the 16th of September. Warren Raymond, Wiskowski Powell, Zions Powell. As an information, Father Christian Fini comes as a proxy for Father Peter Daly, Provincial Superior of Australia, member ex officio of the chapter, who is incapacitated to join because of health reasons. The doctor doesn't allow him to travel, though he's healthy, not in a serious situation, but the travel is very long from Australia. So the replacement has been done according to the directions given in our constitutional rules, is the rule 128C.
Thank you, Father Logan English. Thank you, Father Claudio. Given that all the legal requirements are fulfilled, we are now ready for the official opening of the general chapter. At this assembly, As Constitution 125 says, let us together, in union with the Church, discern God's will in the urgent needs of our times, and thank the Lord for the work of salvation which he accomplishes through us. I hereby declare opened the 36th General Chapter of the Missionary Oblates of Mary Immaculate. So with that joy, I share with you a very sad piece of news that just before Mass, I was told this morning in the General House, Father Kennedy Katongo was found in his room dead. So we extend our sorrow to Father Freeborn and the scholastics from Zambia and to the whole congregation. He was the coordinator for justice and peace and the integrity of creation. And he has a wonderful companion for us as a gift for the chapter. The new Vade Mecum has been printed. So we're deeply distressed, and I think somehow we should keep the mourning of this day and maybe tomorrow also in his memory, in thanksgiving for his life and vocation. I do not know more details. The doctor was going to the General House this morning to find out the cause. So better that not speculate. Father Thomas Klosterkamp, the superior, asked us not to go to the General House at least before 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We shouldn't go there. I'm sure they will give us some news about whether there will be a viewing of his body or a funeral, a mass, maybe these days. So we just keep him in our prayers and continue. The founder would say we have another brother in heaven, huh? Our company of saints has grown. So we sure, maybe it's a sign or a good message that we all be more committed to the ministry of justice and peace and integrity of creation. So a moment of silent prayer, okay, at this time. Pater noster, qui es in caelis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in caelo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis. Tentationem, sed libera nos a malo. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta. Mortis nostri, Ave. Gloria al Padre, al Hijo, e al Spirito Santo, sicut erat in principio, nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, let perpetual light shine. May he rest in peace. Amen. So, if you would go to the document 2.3.1 for the presentation and approval of the officers and personnel of the chapter. first of all, not an approval, I should say, but a presentation in 2014, September, the Superior in General and Council appointed the pre-chapter commission. So I'd like to present them to you. You already know Father Claudio Bertuccio. Oh, he stepped in the background. He is the commissioner of the pre-chapter commission and has worked long and hard preparing this month. I thank Father Jerry de los Reyes from the delegation of Thailand, Laos, for agreeing to free Father Claudio up for this work. He has done a tremendous job, and we're very grateful, and I hope you extend our gratitude to the delegation. Thank you. The members of the commission also, Father Martin Wolf from the Central European province. I thank Father Stefan Obergfell for letting Father Martin work with us. And also Father Emmanuel Youngton, who is translating, I think, at this point in one of the booths in the back. I thank Father Edouard in the region of Africa, that Madagascar, that allowed Father Emmanuel to do this work also. So thank you very much. Always in the background, the secretary was Father Bill O'Donnell, who's probably working somewhere right now, and also my representative. I was the, what am I called, the president, I guess, of the commission. I was the president, but Cornelius did all the work for me as my representative, so I thank Father Bill O'Donnell and Cornelius. Okay. So first of all, we have three moderators here in the front, and we want to hopefully approve them. Father Bernard Karadek is at my right here. And I thank our mother province, France, for allowing him to be here. After him is Father Ramon Bernabe from the Philippines. Thank you, Father. Thanks to Father Larry. And then we have, oh, way back there, Father Jean-Eric Jasmin from Haiti, Colombia. So we thank Father Ludige and the Colombian Oblate. So the first thing we want to do is approve these great Oblates as moderators of this chapter. So I will ask for a show of hands. So all those who approve Father Bernard Karadek, Father Ramon Bernabe, and Father Jean-Eric Jasmin as moderators of this chapter, please raise your hands. Wow, it looks great, okay? Should I say something official? No, okay. The next person we want to approve is to my left at the end of the table. The recording secretary is Father Jim Allen from the U.S. province, and I thank his provincial for giving the okay. So he is our recording secretary. He'll be, you know, recording all that we say and do and sneeze and cough. So all those in favor of Jim Allen as recording secretary, please raise your hands. Thank you. Huh? Unanimous, huh? And we thank Jim for all the work he's doing also from the States for the congregation in communique and information, and I don't know all else that he does, proofreading and translating. So thank you, Jim, for coming. And finally, very important also, is our chapter secretary, who is Father Marek Yazger. Is he here? Oh, there he is. Okay, would you stand up so people know you, huh? Oh, we did not approve him yet. Don't, well, maybe that was the approval, huh? All those who approve Marek, Father Marek as chapter secretary, please raise your hand. Thank you. Wonderful. Okay, another unanimous. So if you look at that list, we're going to approve all the others in a group way. I won't read them all out, but take a minute to look down the list, and then I will ask for your approval of all the other helpers. Canon Law Consultant Committee, Liturgy, Secretariat, IT, Hospitality, Infirmary, Communications, Ambiance, Decoration, Translations, Simultaneous and Written, okay, all those in favor of approving the auxiliary personnel of the chapter, please raise your hands. Okay, thank you. They will work very hard, and we thank all of them. Okay, big applause.
Now, I am expected to give you an overview of the chapter. The preparation started about 2 years ago with the appointment of the pre-capitular commission. This chapter is a special occasion because it falls in the year we are celebrating the 200th anniversary of our congregation. Since the beginning, it was clear that as a family, we wanted it to be a time of grace, a time of the Spirit, thanking God for what He has given us until today, and also listening to Him to better understand the direction in which He is leading us now. There were three main phases of the preparation. First of all, the choice of the main theme and the connected animation of the congregation on this topic. The second phase was the remote preparation, organizing for the membership, the ex officio elected and invited delegates, preparing also the auxiliary personnel and the program for the meeting, animating and giving information to capitulars and auxiliary personnel, asking for and sending of documents, the reports, for example. Finally, the third moment was the immediate preparation, preparing for room and board, all practical and material things needed, the coordination of the various committees, and so on. Now, we are all gathered here, and we have just begun the chapter. What are we going to do? I must acknowledge it is very difficult to answer this question. I really don't know. But I can present to you what we, as the pre-chapter commission, have prepared and recommend to you now. I say I don't know because you have the authority to change whatever we have prepared. So we can tell you what we have prepared. In this chapter, we for you three main moments. First of all, there will be a kind of introduction, what we are doing now. So it's a time of setting up the organization of the chapter so that our machine can run. It will concretely be today and tomorrow. tomorrow, with the election of the steering committee, we can start our first important moment, which is looking at the past with gratitude. In the first week, as you can see in what is written in the calendar that is shown above your heads, our heads. So in the first week, we will listen to all the reports of the regions, the brothers' report, Father General's report on the state of the congregation and on our finances. Though the one of the finances will be presented by the General Treasurer, but it's the same report. Even among our shortcomings, we will give thanks to God with Mary because he has done great things for us. Once all the reports have been listened to, we will start the second important moment, which we can title Living the Present with Passion. And so in the second week, you will start reflecting on the present situation of our mission and its connections with our life. Passion for Christ, for the church, and for the people entrusted to us is like the engine moving our life and mission. In the preparatory commission, we tried to integrate the chapter's theme with the responses to the questionnaire sent to all oblates, and with the material of the triennium program in preparation to our Jubilee, especially the last year on mission. What came out is this proposal for the structure of your reflection. As you can see, details are in the sheets. That document is 1.2, is also printed in your folders, so you can also give a look at it there. I don't present in detail day after day because that program is just our proposals. Once there is a steering committee, they will have to decide if they go on with that or if they will find a better way to present. Once the reflection on the theme will be stopped or finished for the moment, we will start the third moment, which is the last important moment of our chapter, which we can call Imagining the Future with Audacity. So in the third week, if we move to the other, we will start imagining the future of our mission and choosing the people that will lead us for the next 6 years. Some indication concerning formation and mission will be prepared by your work. Also, the elections of the new central government will take place at this stage. And finally, will be time for conclusion. So, in the last week, you will wrap up all your work by offering some directives for the future of our mission, both to the whole congregation and to the new central government. This is what I can say about the overview of the chapter. But before I finish this short presentation, allow me to say a few words of thanks. I would like to thank Father General and his council for having given me the opportunity to offer this service to the congregation. Though sometimes it has been quite demanding, it has certainly helped me to grow in knowledge and love for our family, even in its shortcomings. I would also like to thank all the members of the Precapitular Commission and its secretary for the fraternity we shared together with our work. Without them, it would have been very difficult for me to reach this day. Lastly, I would like to thank all the members of the congregation the auxiliary personnel, and all of you for your availability and cooperation in preparing for these days. Each one, in his own way and in various degrees, has helped me in the preparation of this chapter. Now I think I have accomplished the task assigned to me, so I assure you of my prayer, and may God bless you during this chapter. Thank you.
Thank you, Claudio. He is like John the Baptist. He is now decreasing so the chapter can increase. Huh? The chapter has begun. The work of the pre-chapter commission has finished. He has graciously said he would stay here a few days to make sure we get going. So we are grateful to you. Thank you. The next point is the presentation and approval of the chapter directory. I know you have all studied and pondered over the chapter directory. I will give a short overview, a short presentation, and then we will move to approving it, because this is the document that, as Father Claudio said, is the machine will start working, but it needs a guide. The directory is the guide. As you remember, the norms of the chapter directory are intended as a supplement to the constitution and rules of the congregation, as a supplement to the common norms of canon law, the application, our application. The chapter directory is a guide, a roadmap for our work throughout the whole month. The chapter directory begins beautifully, reminding us of the nature and aims of the general chapter, strengthening the bonds of unity among us, providing a place and a time for sharing about our mission, our missionary lives, to provide a forum of participation in the direction of the congregation. This is the highest authority. So the direction, where are we going? To be a time of discernment and conversion. What is God asking of us? Not what do we want to do, what do we think we should do, that's part of it, but what does God call us to? As I said, it's the highest authority in the congregation. To remember the chapter preparation, Father Claudio indicated this. As I said, in 2014, the commission was appointed. On December 21st, 2014, the anniversary of the ordination of St. Eugene, a letter convoking the chapter was sent out. So we've been working, huh, since the interchapter, preparing for this. And the chapter, the pre-chapter commission, sent out information regarding the procedures on how to elect the delegates for the chapter in each region. And now we come to the organization of the chapter. It's number 46 and onward in your directory. This is what we will be following especially closely these days. This section of the directory will guide our work for the coming days and weeks. It will give flesh to the various dimensions of our work in the coming days so that the chapter will function legitimately. We will proceed step by step in these first 2 days and gradually understand how everything works together to achieve the goals of the chapter. So it's good, again, when you have some free time to look at this section, chapter preparation, from number 46 onward. The chapter directory has been sent out 3 months ago in June for your perusal, your study, your reading. The pre-chapter commission has not received any suggestions to modify, to change, to add, or delete anything from the directory during these 3 months. So it seems like we could move ahead to approve this document so that the chapter will be able to function. So that is my proposal now, that by raising our hands, we show approval of the chapter directory for the 36th general chapter. So all those in favor of approving this directory, please raise your hands. Wow, that's fantastic. Thank you. Maybe we could applaud for approving the directory.
Bernard Keraduc, en français. Merci au Père Louis pour cette introduction et la présentation de tout le personnel et aussi du directoire du chapitre. Je vous le rappelle aussi pour ceux d'entre vous qui voudraient avoir une copie papier de ce directoire du chapitre, bien que vous l'ayez en forme électronique. Vous verrez dans vos documents au feuillet 2.8, il y a un formulaire que vous pouvez remplir et que vous transmettez au secrétariat pour avoir une copie papier d'un document. Et vous spécifiez bien sûr en quelle langue vous le désirez. Il y a maintenant quelques annonces à vous faire. C'est toujours un peu de cette manière que ça commence aussi les chapitres, parce qu'il y a des choses pratico-pratiques à vous communiquer. Alors, nous commençons par des choses vraiment pratiques. À la page 2.4 de vos documents, vous avez quelques éclaircissements sur la buanderie. On va en parler parce qu'il y a un petit changement qui a été apporté à ce qui est écrit. À partir de la semaine prochaine, c'est-à-dire à partir de lundi matin, ou du dimanche, si l'on considère que le dimanche est le premier jour de la semaine, vous pouvez déposer vos vêtements, votre linge qui est à laver, le mercredi matin, avant 7h30 du matin, dans l'endroit qui sera attribué près du secrétariat, près des casiers. Veillez à ce que votre linge soit marqué, ou bien par votre nom, au numéro d'oblation ou toute autre manière, mais alors veuillez l'inscrire sur le papier, sur votre sac, hein, pour qu'on puisse vous redonner vos effets, redonner les effets à la bonne personne. Il vous sera rendu le vendredi dans l'après-midi. pour cette semaine, nous sommes déjà mercredi, donc c'est impossible de suivre ce calendrier. Un premier ramassage sera fait demain, jeudi, avant 7h30. Et il vous sera rendu ou bien vendredi soir, ou bien samedi dans la matinée au plus tard. Est-ce clair ?
À savoir, le sac pour mettre le linge sale vous sera donné pendant la journée, il sera dans les cassiers près du secrétariat. On aurait dû déjà le faire à cause de ce qui s'est passé à la maison générale, on est un peu en retard, mais avant ce soir, vous aurez le sac pour le linge.
Merci, Claudio. On passe maintenant au repas. Alors, vous pourrez lire aussi 2.4, numéro 5 et autre chose dans vos documents. Mais on vous demande, pour tous les repas où vous serez absent, donc on vous demande de signaler votre absence au repas au moins 3 jours auparavant. Des listes sont affichées près de l'entrée du restaurant et donc vous pouvez mettre un signe en face de votre nom pour indiquer que vous serez absent. Essayons d'y être attentifs parce que si vous ne signalez pas votre absence, eh bien vous êtes automatiquement compté. C'est quand même dommage de payer pour des repas où nous ne serons pas là. Et essayez de le faire surtout pendant les week-ends, parce que tout à l'heure vont être proposées des sorties, des visites, de ci et de là, et vous serez peut-être absent samedi ou le dimanche. Est-ce clair, là aussi ? Maintenant, la santé, soins médicaux. Une infirmière sera présente le lundi soir à 20h à la réception de l'hôtellerie s'il y a des personnes qui ont demandé sa présence, qui ont demandé un rendez-vous. Ce rendez-vous doit être demandé avant lundi midi. À la réception de l'hôtellerie, non pas à la réception OMI. S'il n'y a pas de rendez-vous demandé, la personne ne viendra pas, l'infirmière ne viendra pas, hein, et vous devrez attendre une semaine avant de recevoir les soins que vous désiriez peut-être. Maintenant, une autre chose, la sécurité dans les chambres. Il est mieux d'éviter toute tentation pour quiconque. Donc, ne laissez pas traîner d'argent ou d'objets de valeur. Je suppose que vous n'avez pas de boucles d'oreilles, de bagues, de chaînes en or et tout ça, mais ne laissez pas traîner d'argent ni d'objets de valeur dans vos chambres, quand vous n'y êtes pas, bien sûr, ou même billets d'avion ou des choses comme cela. Hein, ça peut tenter des personnes. Ou bien prenez-les avec vous. S'ils sont des objets de valeur, vous pouvez les confier à la réception de l'hôtellerie. Il y a des coffres à cet effet, comme dans les hôtels, du reste. Hein, ceci pour éviter toute déconvenue. Je vais maintenant laisser la parole à Ramon pour il va nous donner une description des excursions qui sont prévues. Hein, puisque nous avons un peu de temps, on peut déjà l'entendre.
Bernabe in English. These programs have been provided by Father Thomas Klosterkamp for our Sundays, and that those who wish to participate in any of these programs are invited to list up for any of these. So first, meals at the General House must be signed in Thursday before. Okay, so every Thursday, if you need to have meals at the General House on Sundays, kindly list up by Thursday noontime. Lunch at the General House is at 1300 and dinner is at 1930. On Sunday also, there will be a program for visiting Rome with Eugene de Mazenod. It will be facilitated by Father Fabio Ciardi for a maximum of 10 persons only. So this is for Sunday, September 18, 2016, visiting Rome with Eugene de Mazenod. The tour will be given in different languages. Translations will also be organized within the group. And the departure time is at 8 o'clock in the morning, and you will be going by public transportation. Bus tickets are needed. Small lunch will also be taken during the day. Eucharist will not be celebrated together on Sunday, and the return will be in the early afternoon. So that's the short description of this program, Visiting Rome with Eugene de Mazenod with Father Fabio. The next suggested program is a tour to Assisi, this time for a maximum of 15 persons. The guide will be Father Peter Foley, and the tour will be given in English. Translations should be organized within the group. So among those who will be present in that tour, you can organize who to translate from English. Departure will also be at 8 o'clock in the morning by bus. Reservations for lunch will be made at a restaurant in Assisi. Again, Eucharist will not be celebrated together, and departure from Assisi back to Rome will be at 1700. We should be back here by supper time. The next suggested program is a tour to Subiaco for a maximum of 23 persons. The guides are Father Marcin Sorbin and Father Bonga Mayola. The tour will be in English, and again, translations should be organized within the group for those who are coming. Departure is at 9 o'clock in the morning. Lunch will be reserved at a sister's convent. Eucharist will not be celebrated together, and the departure time from Subiaco will be at about 1600. And again, you are expected to be back in Rome for supper time. The last proposed program is visiting the Domitila Catacombs for a maximum of 24 persons. The guide will be Father Thomas Klosterkamp. The tour will be given in English, but on the following Sundays, the tour will also be given in French and in Spanish. The departure time is at 9:30 in the morning, and at 10:30, the tour starts in English. 11:30, the Eucharist will be celebrated together in the catacombs, and so we request those joining the tour to bring an alb and a stole for those intending to concelebrate. Again, reservations for lunch will be made at a restaurant by the staff of the catacombs. You're expected to be back here in the early afternoon. So we expect that there will be a list at the reception area where people can write up and sign up. At the OMI reception area here at the brother's house, not at the reception of Casa LaSalle. Okay, so please go to the OMI reception area and look for the sign up sheet and take note of the number of maximum participants only per tour group. Claudio, other details?
Just a detail. These same programs will be offered, for what I know, every Sunday. So you can choose if you want to go to one place this Sunday and to another place another Sunday. Only be aware that for the last one, the Domitilla Catacombs there, it will be every Sunday in a different language. They start this Sunday in English, the following one, I don't remember what language, but it will be every Sunday a different language.
Deux dernières choses. En début d'après-midi, viendront nous donner quelques renseignements les gens de l'Internet. C'est toujours utile d'avoir quelques éclaircissements. Et enfin, avant que nous clôturions cette première session, et nous prenions notre repas à 1h tout à l'heure, il y a aujourd'hui, 14 septembre, des fêtes et anniversaires à souhaiter, et c'est l'occasion quand on prend notre repas ensemble. Sans vouloir oublier personne, je pense, José Luis Castillo, c'est l'anniversaire d'ordination. Voilà. Et c'est 20 ans, je crois. 20 years. Hein? 20 ans d'ordination. Voilà. Vincent Gruber qui fête ses premiers vœux, 1985. Oh. Ignacio Royce Alonso, les vœux perpétuels, je pense, 85. Ainsi que Diego Saez, les vœux perpétuels, en 2002, beaucoup plus récemment.
A word more about Father Kennedy. Thomas Klosterkamp called us, and he said the doctor verified he died of a heart attack. And the general house is open now, anytime anybody wants to go up to view after the meal, not at 4 o'clock, but after the meal, you're free to go up to the general house, okay? And I do not have the leaflet for the closing prayer. In big print. Thank you, merci. Prions. Tu nous as réunis, Seigneur, pour que nous cherchions ensemble ta volonté. Mets à nous le désir de ce qui est vrai. Tiens-nous dans un esprit de paix. Et quand nous aurons vu ce que tu demandes, aide-nous à l'accomplir d'un même cœur. Par Jésus-Christ, ton Fils, notre Seigneur et notre Dieu, qui règne avec toi et le Saint-Esprit, maintenant et pour les siècles des siècles.
Amen.
Angelus Domini annunciavit Mariae. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria,
Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostri. Amen. Ecce ancilla Domini. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostri. Amen.
Et verbum caro factum est. Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus. Ora pro nobis sancte Dei genitrix. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.